Bhagavatamritam Tapta Jivanam Kaviviriditam Kalmasapaham Shravanamangalam Sri Madatatam Bhuvigrinanti Guridayana. From the Gopi Gita. The nectar of thy words is the life for those who are scorched by the world. The words which have been uttered by the knowers of truth, which wipe out sins, the very hearing of which is beneficial, which are beautiful, pleasing to the ears, pleasing to the hearts, which are inexhaustible. Those who recount them on the earth are the givers of plenty. Om Shanti, 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 peace, 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 be sound okay?
Yes, Mother,
yes. As Swami Prapannananda Ji has said, my topic, spiritual teachings of Swami Vishuddhananda Ji Maharaj. Last year also I spoke gems from the Garden of Saints, from the same series of talk. Before I begin my subject, I shall try to give you a little introduction. Why spiritual life is so important in our life? Why? Why do we need God in our life? You can buy anything in the market, but you cannot buy peace and bliss. That comes from spiritual life. What is vital in human life? Ananda, bliss. The Upanishad tells us, Ananda Deva Khallimani Bhutani Jayante, Anandena Jatani Jivanti, Ananda Prayanta Visambishanti, Tadvijikansaswa, Tadbrahmeti. This whole creation evolves from bliss. It just stays in bliss and it merges into bliss. Bliss is the guiding force. We want money. Why? So that we may get joy. We get married. We get one children. We have home. We want car. Everything for joy, for bliss. Bliss is the guiding force. And that comes only through spiritual life. You cannot buy from the supermarket. Second, this human life is very, very precious. Extremely precious. When I see some people misusing their lifetime, I feel bad. In Shankara's commentary, one place in Chandogya Upanishad, he mentioned how difficult it is to get a human life. These jivatmas, individual souls, come panchagni vidya from purjena, it goes to the cloud, then rain, then food, then man's body, then it wants to enter woman's body. How difficult to get us, take this human body. Amazing. Why do we have this human body? Because only in this body you can realize God. Devo Sharira, divine body, has no action there. Subhuman, animal body, there is no action there. Action, this is the karma kshetra, this world. You can change. You can be very bad, you can be very good. This is possible only in human body. God gave us intellect. We can discriminate. That is not possible in any other body. Devo sharira, bhoga sharira. That body is for enjoyment. You did good action, you will enjoy in heaven. But in this manushya sharira, this human body, really you can do something. You can make yourself God, you can make yourself a brute, animal. Everything is in our hands. Third point I want to tell you as my introduction, our order. Sometimes I say Ramakrishna order is very young, very small, poor compared to other religious organizations. But our organization is very rich, extremely rich about our spiritual treasures. We inherit. I am quite often used to say, Pitar Vishwajya Putre Paar. Father's wealth goes to his children. When the parents die, who inherit the children, wealth? Children. So Sri Ramakrishna's spiritual wealth, we inherit. We are his children, including you also, the devotees. We are all children of Sri Ramakrishna. Now, I was thinking this morning that, you know, Sri Ramakrishna opened a spiritual lab in Dakshineshwar. Really a lab. He, like a scientist. What do the scientists do? Experiment, verify. Experiment, verify. In this way, they come to the conclusion. So, Sri Ramakrishna did all experiments and verified for 23, 24 years. Then the disciples came. From 1855 to 1879, Sri Ramakrishna was working in his lab. What will work, what does not work. Then he gave all his findings to his disciples. Disciples came. When the father flower blooms, bees come. If the flower is hidden in a deep forest, bees know where the honey is. They go. Came, disciples. Sri Ramakrishna cried for them. I was thinking, look, Swamiji came. Have you seen God? Yes. And I see you more than I see you. I saw God more intensely than I see you. What does it mean? You see, when Sri Ramakrishna, I see here is a person, this is her face, this is her cloth, this is her shoe, this is the thing we see with our this mortal eyes. Sri Ramakrishna not only sees the body, he sees that person mind, samskaras, he sees that person's past, present, future, everything. He sarvajna, God, sees everything. And he can change if he wishes. As Swamiji said, Sri Ramakrishna could take the human mind like a lump of clay, and it can squeeze, it can give shape any ways he likes. Swami Brahmananda came. He was passing through a very dry spell, which sometimes we do, dark night of the soul. Very painful. Then he was thinking to leave Sri Ramakrishna. I don't want to come. You get me initiation, Ramakrishna will take care of me. It's difficult sometimes to give initiation, I tell you. Now, Japam and meditation, spiritual practices are very, very vital, very, very important. Swami Vishuddhananda said, let me tell you, the God realization does not depend on your japam and meditation. Then it will be market commodity. I have repeating 1,000,000 mantras I must seek out. God vision comes by the grace of God. Then why should we practice meditation? Then he told that the story of the bird who sat on the mast of the ship. It was also another Ramakrishna's parable. The boat left the harbor, went into deep sea. A bird was seated on the mast. The bird now wants to come back to the shore. What did he do? He flew to the east. Water and water. Wings are tired, came back to the port. West, south, north, all directions the bird flew and flew. Tired, exhausted, and then decided, by the help of this boat, I shall have to cross the ocean. There is no other way I can go back to the shore. I tried. Same thing about the spiritual life. Vedantaji used to say, Dhyana Batha. Japam and meditation I do just to tire the wings. It will not work. But if you are sincere, help will come. Masculine Paki. Tat prasadat param shantim sthanam prakshasi shashvatam. That peace will come when we completely surrender ourselves to God. Swami discussed there are two types of bhakti, vaidhi bhakti, para bhakti. Vaidhi bhakti means preparatory devotion. I shall do the puja, I shall bring flowers, I shall make sanjal paste, I shall light the candle, I shall do my offer food. This is all vaidhi bhakti, that we do in the temple. Parabhakti, supreme devotion comes from intense love. Sa para unurakti shari. Shangela says, what is devotion? Para anurakti. Supreme attachment for God is called devotion. We understand attachment. Attachment for husband, wife, children, money, family, property, all these things. But we do not learn how to attach to be God. Attach to God. That we do not learn. That is the reason we have all problems. Para. Supreme devotion. We find the gopis in the Vrindavan. They had parabhakti, supreme devotion. When Krishna sent to Uddhava, console those girls that I am everywhere. Why do they cry for me? Although I am in Mathura, 7 miles away from Vrindavan. So Krishna Uddhava came, Krishna was and trying to console these gopis. Why are you crying? Meditate on Krishna. Krishna is in your heart, Krishna is everywhere. Then the gopis replied, Uddhava, you are a jnani. You do not know, have anything about love. Tell me, what do you need for practicing meditation? What do you need? You need a mind. Without mind you cannot meditate. We have no minds. Krishna stole our minds. Our minds are not in our bodies. They have gone to Krishna. All the time our minds are there. Oh, Krishna asked me to tell all of you that try to meditate and do karma yoga, this and that. We have nothing to do. We only have asked Krishna, please give us two things. He wanted to give us knowledge of Brahman and all this. Those are all neglected, bad things, very negligible things, knowledge of Brahman. We want two things. What do you want? We want to love you and we want to serve you. Nothing else. That is called Prabhakti. You know the person you really love, you carry that person in your heart. And you want to give your everything to that person. All human beings, you will always remember, we are all carrying somebody in our hearts. Those who carry all the time in their hearts, God, Pandava Gita says, Nitto Chava Bhavetti Sham Nitto Sri Nitto Mangalam Yesham Ridista Bhagavan Mangalayatanam Hari. Nitto Chava Utshava, festivity. That person enjoys festivity all the time. Nitto Sri Nitto Mangalam Sri, all beauty, wealth, mangal, all good, comes to that person. Who? To whom? Yesham Ridista Bhagavan Mangalayatanam Hari. Who carries the blissful Lord in our hearts? Everything will come to you. Jesus said, first seek the kingdom of heaven and everything shall be added into you. Seek and ye shall find. Knock, it shall go. Ask and ye shall find. Seek, knock, and this door will be opened unto you. We'll have to knock, that's all. That Swami says, Vaidhi Bhakti and Raga Bhakti, Parabhakti. Then Sinami quoted Sri Ramakrishna's example. When in India, we have palm leaf fan. In our village, we did not have any electricity. So, fan. But when the gentle breeze blows, you don't need any fan. That is called grace. Just unfurl the sail, say, the breeze will take your boat to the destination. That's Sri Ramakrishna said. That is your job. How to unfurl the sail? The breeze is always blowing. God's grace is always coming to us, but you do not know how to receive it. Then Swami gave couple of examples of the Parabhakti, supreme devotion. You see, I was born and brought up in a village, both sides meadows, thousands and thousands of acres of paddy field, river, rain 120 inches, rainfall a year, planted. Other times you will go by no boat to a destination by the river or the canal. But when every place is flooded, you can go over the street also, the car, your boat. That's what I'm saying. That when everything is flooded, you do not need to go follow the rules and regulations. Straight you can go. It is just like the plane, you know, they have the jet route that you go this 30,000 feet, you go 40,000 feet. The control tower guides this plane that you go this direction, you go this direction, so that you do not hit each other. So at that time, they know the direction. That will go straight. Then one other thing says that river and the banna, when the flood comes, you can go straight, that is quick. Another also, in the field, paddy field, you will go zigzag in the winter rainy season, but when the harvest is over, they go shortcut. We want shortcut. Shortcut. We want to reach our destination quickly. That Swami was talking. We want to go back very quickly. Go to our destination. What can Guru do to you? You will have to walk, remember. Guru can give you a pair of shoes. Guru can give you an umbrella. Guru can give you some water to drink. But you will have to move. That is very, very important to the disciples. If you move one step, God will come 100 steps toward you. Sri Ramakrishna said, he never knew anything other than mother. Mother, take me this good and evil, give me pure love, give me this virtue, take this virtue and vice, give me devotion. Take this dharma, take this adharma, give me devotion. That Sri Ramakrishna said. In his spiritual life, according to Patanjali Yoga Sutra, there are 4 things. I'm talking about obstacles. Obstacles in spiritual life. First is called Prathama Kulpika. Second, Madhu Bhumika. Third, Prajna Jyoti. Fourth, Otikranta Bhavaniya. In the Yoga Sutra, Vyasa commented, Prathama Kulpika means just a beginner. You have started your spiritual journey. You made your shrine, you meditate regularly, you give up all of your bad habits and you are trying to control your mind to some extent. You have controlled some of your things, you know. That time is just fine. In the second stage, they call it Madhubhumika. Madhubhumika means Madhu means honey. You have begun to taste the divine bliss. And then you are excited. At that time you have pretty control over the senses. And do you know what happens at that time? Temptation comes. All temptations will come in the second stage. In the Yoga Sutra, Vyasa says, Kamaniyogo Kanta, enjoy these beautiful girls. Have plenty of money. Whatever you need, everything you will get. Because the gods become jealous. Well, this person, yogi, wants to surpass us. We are suffering with enjoyment in heaven. Don't think that enjoyment is always good. Well, we are suffering from the enjoyment of heaven. So, what to do? Well, just enjoy this thing. Well, they are, because they will go to Nirvana and gods are stuck in enjoyment. So, what happens? At that time, all temptations come. And there are many yogis fall. If you can overcome that temptation, then comes Prajna Jyoti. Do you know Prajna Jyoti means? X-ray vision. He can see the Maya is coming. He can see everything. And he knows that if I get involved, what will happen? As if I shall fall from the top of the Everest and on the ground. 30 years, 40 years in his spiritual life, will be finished in the twinkling of an eye. I remember, I am now writing my memoirs of the old Swami, so I still remember. It is funny, but don't mind. I was asking Maharaj, how shall we handle with the people outside this and that? Then he told me, he's an old Swami. Listen, I tell you, my boy, suppose you are sent to work in a hospital. And you go and serve there. Suppose a girl, young girl has come, very sick, and perhaps she had an accident, and you are supposed to give some kind of treatment or some kind of bandage to her feet or something like that. But that is your job, you do. That doesn't mean you will have to write a love letter to that girl, right? I'll just join the monastery, you know. You do your job, that doesn't mean you have to write a love letter to that girl. Oh my goodness, what is this? I have never heard such thing in my life. All sadhus, they have no control, you know. They will tell you what is good for you. X-ray vision. Sometimes don't think bad thoughts do not come to the yogi. They see they are coming from it. Then Sri Ramakrishna took him to the temple. He sat on the in the Natmandira for meditation. Sri Ramakrishna entered the Kali temple. And then he came back to his room. And Brahmananda, within short period, came back to Sri Ramakrishna's room. Look, why did you come so early? You are not supposed to come so quickly. Master, I saw a light came from the mother and I could not bear it. So I ran away. You were complaining that you are not getting any visions. Now even you get and you cannot hold it. You know, Swamiji said in America, ordinary people preach religion, but Sri Ramakrishna could give religion. His one touch, one glance can change a person's life. Each disciple, I gave a series of talk how Ramakrishna's instructions to his disciples. How they trained. Lati Maharaj fell asleep in the evening. I don't need your service, you go. Sir, please give me another chance. He struggled 3 months and never slept all night in sleep at night. He never slept at night all night. When we used to read these stories, is it possible? It is possible. You know, it is not easy to live with Ramakrishna. Sometimes you may think that, oh, if you can live with Master, how wonderful it is. I used to tell in Hollywood, you know, suppose you are lying in bed, Jesus Christ appeared before you, what will you do? You'll be scared to death, you will call 9-11. God, it is good you stand on the kitchen and you want that is a very good place. Please don't come here. I am happy here. It is not so easy to live with this kind of divine being. Swami Premananda said, you know, when we went to the Master, I used to pray because during his samadhi somebody will have to hold him, otherwise he will fall. And if any impure person holds him, he will cry, oof, don't touch me. That will expose you that you are not pure enough. So it is not easy to live with Sri Ramakrishna. Swami Ramakrishnananda brought some books and was reading Sufi literature. He was reading Persian, thinking that Sufi mysticism, very great stories I must read. Sri Ramakrishna called 2-3 times, he did not answer. Then Sri Ramakrishna said, my boy, if you read those books, you will not get devotion. You are neglecting the service to your guru. What did he do? He took all the books and threw away into the Ganges. Now, what my guru said, I shall follow. Each disciple, I cannot tell all the stories, really, really unique. Swami Advaitananda came, lost his wife in old age, crying all the time. One of his friends said, go to Dakshineshwar. First time he came to Dakshineshwar, met Sri Ramakrishna. He found that Sri Ramakrishna is an ordinary person. Then his friend said, go back. Sometimes they test you. This holy people, again he came back, he felt the same way. Then he went home, found that master in everybody. You see, that is called possessed. When? How? God will possess you, you do not know. Time factor is there. But never give up. Anyhow, I shall start. I can tell many stories about the Jari disciples, but our topic is Swami Vishuddhananda, this conversation. This Swami we met many times. He was born in 1883, died in 1962. A disciple of Holy Mother. He used to go different places and give spiritual discourses in the afternoon. Devotees would come and sit there. Some days he used to take a talk about the Gospel or Gita and transported them. You see, if you want devotion, according to Chaitanya, you need five things. First, sadhu sangha, holy company. Second, naam, chanting God's name. Third, Krishna seva, worshipping the Lord. Fourth, Bhagavad, reading the holy scripture, devotional scriptures. Fifth, Tirthavas, living in a holy place. Holy company. Holy company is very, very important. So these people would come to have the holy company of Swami Vishuddhananda. So that we see, you know, that how he used to inspire people. You know, when the one I say Naam, chanting God's name, it reminds me a verse of Rupa Goswami in Vidagdha Madhav, in the opening, he made this statement how name works. That verse is so poetic, I shall repeat to you. Sunje tanjavanitanum vitunite tinjabarilabdai karna krodo kotamini ghatate karnur pradibhu spriham chita prangana sangini bhajpijate sarvindriyanam kritim no jane janita kiyodvi krishna iti parnetri. Tunje tanjavanitanu, tunja, tongue. When this name vibrates on my tongue, Krishna, Krishna, Krishna. Do you know how do I feel? I am not happy. Why? Because I have one tongue. I want millions of tongues. And these 2 years, I am not happy. I want millions of years so that I can hear the name of my beloved. And do you know what? When that name, Cheto Prangmana Sangini, when that name vibrates in my mind, Sarvindriyanam Kritim, all my sense organs collapse. They become calm, still. They do not function. Only God vibrates in my name. I do not know what a magic inside that name. Beautiful analogy. No. Worship. Devotional scriptures, reading, read. your meditation will be supported by reading. I was asking one day Swami Vishuddhananda, Maharaj, could you teach me how do you meditate? He was the principal of our training center. Do you want to know my secret? And yes. In the evening, I read four verses of Viveka Chudamani, Gradual of Discrimination, before I meditate. And that chops up all day's thoughts. I disconnect the world through those four verses of Gradual of Discrimination. Then I start my meditation. You know, some people read one or two pages of the Gospel, then they start meditation. Then they can visualize. You know, everything is not in the book. These monks, the experiment that I was talking to you, is Swami Vishuddhananda ji experiment. And his words are so penetrating. Ramakrishna Mission, Shillong, 24th March 1957. Swami started self-surrender. Asked the devotees how to surrender to God. He quoted from the Gita, Sarva Dharman Purityajya Mamekam Sharanam Bhaja Aham Tvam Sarva Pape Bhu Moksha Ishyami Masucha. Give up all of your duties, surrender yourself to me. I shall protect you from all sins, all problems. Masucha, do not grieve. He started. You know, then he said, Sharanagati is very, very important, self-surrender. Through self-surrender only you can get supreme peace. Then he talked about there are two types of devotees. Sri Ramakrishna said that one kind of devotee is like baby monkey and the kitten. Baby monkey holds the mother and jumps from the water to one tree to the another. And the kittens, the mother cat, wherever they can, she carries, the baby monkey goes there. Baby cat, the kitten goes there. That story you know, he mentioned. Whether Ramakrishna's teachings are experimented or not. There was a brahmachari named Ram Maharaj in Almora. He experimented Ramakrishna's teaching, Ramevicha. Everything is the will of Rama. It was a parable of Dukshin Ramakrishna. Sri Ramakrishna said, there is a weaver, very virtuous man. He was repeating God's name. The robbers picked him up. They robbed, put all the luggage on this holy man's, good man's heart, shoulder. And in the meantime, police chased, the robbers ran away, this man was caught, he was in jail. Then he was brought in front of the judge. The villagers came, no, he cannot be a robber, please release him. Then he said, please tell me what is your story. I was meditating and repeating God's name. The robbers came, grabbed me, robbed, put the luggage on my head. And then police came, caught me, then I was in jail. Now I am in front of the Ramevicha. By the will of Rama, I am in front of the judge. He was released. By the will of Rama, now I am released. This is the parable I told you very briefly. We know it in the Gospel. This man, or that brahmachari, experimented. Let's see whether Ramevicha works or not. And it worked. I remember one story of his. One Christian missionary came to Almora. He used to live in Almora. And they used to go to Boshishan's house. This missionary came and said, they're talking. Then the Swami asked, actually, Father, shall I be frank with you? Yes, I have a question. Is it the will of Christ that all people in India should be Christians? Yes. Father, shall I be frank with you? You have no faith in Christ. What do you mean? Father, Christ was gone. If it is God's wish, immediately it will happen. It is not Christ's will that all Hindus, all Indians should be Christians. It is you who want this. Thus, he was exposed. Chabidamelitsa. Two things in spiritual life. Self-effort, divine grace. I compare these two blades of the scissors. A cloth can be cut with two blades. One blade cannot cut the cloth. So, both self-effort and grace are necessary. Then, do you know what happened? One of my disciples doesn't want to work, took initiation, and she was practicing. Rasiramdev, Swami, Ramakrishna will take care of me. I shall not work. I told him, then very good, you go and lie down on your bed. And Ramakrishna will cook food and put it into your mouth. If you have that kind of faith, then I have no problem. You please go. Some instance they can stop it. It will not come to you. They have so much power of discrimination. No, don't come to me. They will not come. And then, Maya can attempt them. Pragya will go. But time to time, you may have curiosity. Then you may again fall. But the last stage, Otikranta Bhavaniya. At that time, you are in Jambujet, 42,000 feet, very light air. You can give 600 miles per hour speed and go straight, no obstacles. Really, it happens. Aktana, no obstructions, smooth, thousands of miles it will go. I'm just telling you, there are various layers and stages of spiritual disciplines. But you must make an effort. Raghavakti, Supreme Devotion. Then Swami said, you know, in 1908, when Swami Brahmananda came to Banaras, Swami Brahmananda told me that, you know, one night in Kashipur, Sri Ramakrishna was in bed, cancer, cannot move, very sick. All of a sudden, he told me, hey, bring that picture to me. Which is Sri Ramakrishna, that picture, that shrine post. Bring that picture to me. Well, I took the picture and gave to Sri Ramakrishna. And then he said, bring some flowers. So I brought some flowers. He put the pictures on the flowers and then worshipped him. Worship that picture. And then he said, in the future, this picture will be worshipped in every home. But I still remember Swami Brahmananda told me. You know, I was working for Mother's book. Hopefully the book will be out in September. 876 pages. All of a sudden, a thought came to my mind. Vishuddhananda ji was telling this story. Somebody asked, your mother's disciple, who is great? Sri Ramakrishna is great or mother is great? Then Swami said, you know, I cannot tell you who is great, but Sri Ramakrishna worshipped Holy Mother, that I can tell you. He worshipped his wife. That I can tell you. Who is great, I am not going to tell you, but let me tell you. Both worshipped each other. When Holy Mother came, it was 5th June 1872. Sri Ramakrishna worshipped Holy Mother as Shoruchi on Favaradini Kali Puja night. He gave all of his spiritual sadhana's results to him. Is it not working?
It's working, but it's
I am making too much noise. Yeah, I can hear in the bass. You people put here, right? You don't know. They always used to put here. Here. That is good. Put it down. So that it will not touch my eye. I move too much. then the Swami said, Sri Ramakrishna, first disciple was his wife. 12 years of results of 12 years sadhana he gave to his wife. Because in the future he will have to carry his mission. All the fruits of all, so that if she will not have, you know, if the father earns money, gives to the son enjoys the things. Similarly, Thakur gave all the results of his spiritual fruits to Holy Mother. Then what happened? It is Holy Mother who first started worship of Sri Ramakrishna, not disciples, not devotees. In Nahavad, worship Sri Ramakrishna's picture, one day Sri Ramakrishna came and said, what are you doing here? Oh, so he immediately Sri Ramakrishna sat there and he worshipped his own picture. So in two places we find Sri Ramakrishna worshipped his own picture, you know. So, Holy Mother worships Sri Ramakrishna, Sri Ramakrishna. Then Swami said, do you know what the relationship? Sri Ramakrishna saw his wife. First he saw, she is my wife. Second, she is my disciple. Third, she is my chosen deity, Jagadamba. I see mother in every woman. And what did Holy Mother see? She saw Sri Ramakrishna is my husband. Second, Sri Ramakrishna is my guru. Third, Sri Ramakrishna is my ishta, my chosen deity, my God. You know, I was so, when I book was already composed, I told my composer, this story must go. In that, there is one chapter, two flowers in one stem. How Thakur and Ma both are the same. It is a Purusha and Prakriti, Shiva and Shakti, coming from the same cosmic consciousness. A bird cannot fly with one wing, two wings are necessary, man and woman. How Thakur, Sri Ramakrishna and Holy Mother Swami demonstrated in this age. Anyhow, some Vishuddhananda is that story I shall never forget. As I was continuing, Bhagavan Atya Samarpa and Saranagati. We want to learn and we do not know how to give. We only take. Offer your body, mind, everything. Perhaps you have seen one letter of Swamiji written to Pramodadasmitra. Swamiji went to Pauhari Baba in Ghazipur, 50 miles away from Banaras. I went there 3 times. Swamiji was writing that letter, Til Tulsi Diye Vedeho Ramakrishna Pe Arpan Kurechi. I gave up my body to Sri Ramakrishna. In our country, when you take a vow, do you know what they do? They put Ganges water here, and Til, sesame seed, and Tulsi there, and take a resolution. Well, that is the way I offered my everything to Sri Ramakrishna. See, he is talking detailedly. I remember once, one of our senior Swamis was asking the monks, what do you want? So I want this, I want this. Everybody was asking that, what do they want, did they go? Oh, then the monk, do you know what that the monks, did that monk say? Oh, you have come only to receive, not to give anything. Swamiji was the giver. I am born to give. If you want to give anything, you must have something. Otherwise, what will you give? If you have food, you can give food. If you have knowledge, you can impart knowledge. If you have spirituality, you can impart spirituality. So first gather something, then give. I have no money, I'm giving you $1 million check. Who cares? One of my friends, he was a doctor. He used to tease me. Your life is full of contradictions. I go, what do you mean? Look, you have no money and you are called Maharaj. Maharaj means emperor, you know. Hey Maharaj. You have no money, you are called Maharaj. And you have no wife, you are called Swami. Swami means in our language, Swami means husband. So you have no wife, you are called husband, and you have no money, you are called Maharaj. That's full of contradictions. That's good. If you give, as I said, one of our Swamis used to say, if you cut my rip my breast, my chest, and open it, you will find there is only Ramakrishna and mother, none else. So one of our Swamis had open heart surgery and I asked him, you know that, perhaps you have seen a picture of Hanuman, you know, open it, there is Rama and Sita. So I asked the Swami Maharaj, when they open the rib cage, you know, they cut it and then they open the surgery, what did they see? Hey, you keep quiet. I was telling them, oh, what did they see? What do you do? Sri Ramakrishna mentioned, again he talked about the Ammukta, but the power of atonement, how Thakur gave everything to Holy Mother, the Divine Mother. You know, he demonstrated, I lived in this world 51 years. I have a wife, but I did not build any home. I did not touch money. But I lived very happily for 51 years. Because I surrendered myself to the mother. Mother provided everything to me. Mother served me 14 years. Then came Shambhu, Ravan, then Balaram, Surendra. These people took care of me because I surrendered everything to the mother. Mother provides everything. Sri Ramakrishna demonstrated, without touching money, I can live 51 years. Oh, you know. Think of that. Really, I sometimes think about it. One of our Swamis used to make joke. You know, Sri Ramakrishna says that when people give money, my hand breaks. Our hand also breaks and it squeezes and goes to the pocket. And Sri Ramakrishna says, don't trust any monk who has a boksha, you know, some bandle and the bag. You can trust us, we do not have any boksha, we have leather suitcase. Others have their own jokes. Swami was talking about Sri Ramakrishna's teaching, Jhare Ora Eto Pata. Dry leaves fall on the ground. In whatever wind blows, that leaves go to that direction. That we see in our Saint Louis. In the forest park, in fall, all tree leaves fall, and flower leaves are flying like anything. Watch it. So let be like that leaf, fallen leaves. Whatever direction wind goes, go to that direction. Not so easy. One day, Swami Madhavanandaji was standing, holding the grill of the window of his room in Bellur Math in front of Sri Ramakrishna's temple. That was Jansavitari's room and office. And he was watching. And a young monk was behind. 15 minutes was waiting for him. Then he came back and said, are you here? What do you want? How long are we here? Maharaj, I am here 15 minutes. I am just seeing that you are holding the grill. You are just watching. Could you tell me what are you watching? I am curious. Do you know what I was watching? I was watching the leaves of that coconut tree. 15 minutes, I am watching only the coconut trees. The wind of the Ganges is blowing, and in whatever direction wind blows, the leaves go to that direction. Sometimes this direction, sometimes this direction, it is moving. So I was thinking, if I could be like that kind of leaf of the coconut tree, that in whatever direction Lord will take me, I shall go. That I was watching. You know, sometimes we see these are the things, how the monks, drishtivangi, their outlook. Their outlook, that is really something that we want to see. Then Swami told him, quoted from the verse from the Gita, Ananna Shintanto Mam Yojana Parsat Purjipasate Tesham Nitta Vijuktanam Yogakshimam Bhaimyam. It is in the verse, in the chapter 9. Those who are attached to me, you know, and think of me, and worship me, I carry their everything they need. Then Swami told the story. It is a traditional story that Arjuna Mishra, he was reading that Gita, he was a great Pandit and Shadav, and he is thinking, Bahima, God carries, Bahami Aham, Bahima. God says that I carry. Now, Parasi Gita, it is written in a wrong way. It should be Dadanyaham, I give. God doesn't carry. So he, with a red pen, he cut it and changed it, Dadanyaham. He corrected the Bhagavad Gita. He went to take his bath in the river. His wife found that there was nothing in his room. So in the meantime, a young boy came and he had the three cut marks on the back and brought a big basket of food and other, you know, groceries and all those things, a big basket, and gave to his wife. Then his wife was telling, "My goodness, who beat you, my boy?" "Oh, I cannot tell you, I am very..." "Who is such a cruel person who beat you and cut three marks, red marks on your back?" "No, no, please, you take this basket, I cannot tell all those things, I shall have to go." So the boy left. Then Arjun Mishra came back and heard the whole story from his wife. "Oh, you have seen God. I did it, God carried all everything for me." This is a very traditional story. That Swami, you see, it is Indian folklore has a tremendous impetus to carry the education to the masses. They do not have, many have, do not have any school, college education, but they know religion. They know Mahabharata, Ramayana, Purana. They know morality, ethics. All these things they know through these stories. Oh, that person, you know, you are simple people, they will take it very seriously. God will carry everything for you. Then Swamiji quoted, Swami Vishuddhananda ji quoted Swamiji's story of Pauhari Baba. He had no money. Dildar station, Dildar Nagar station, he stopped, changed the train, and a rich man, he was eating his food, and monk, social, they were called social parasites, you know. Monks are all social parasites, they do not work. The household of people, they earn money, we eat. So he was telling them, "Young man, why don't you go and have a job?" And Swamiji gave to why? Job. Then he was also, you know, he was eating his own lunch, and there, those stations, they, what do they do? Do you know what? Bhistiwala. They carry water in a leather bag and give water to the people, those who are thirsty. Railway workers. So those who can give a little tips, money, they will give you water. And those who are poor people do not give money, they will not perhaps neglect it. So they did not give any water. Swamiji was thirsty. So anyhow, what happened? In the meantime, a man came with a basket of food and a jug of water to Swamiji. And said, "Maharaj, Swamiji, please have this food." "Oh, you do not know me. How do you know this food for me?" "No, no, this food for you." "Well, how do you know?" "Well, yes, I know." Then he told his story. After lunch, I was resting. Lord Rama appeared before me and said, he was a confectioner. He has a sweet shop. They make some food and there is a monk there in that railway station. Please carry that food to that monk. But I was thinking it is a dream, so I took my other side and waiting. Again Lord Rama appeared before me. Again I was neglected. Third time when Rama came, said, "Your everything will be destroyed if you do not listen to me." So I got up and made ruchi, puji, puri and halua and all those things, some sweets. So and water I came to you. You should have this food. And Swamiji ate. And this rich man who was taunting Swamiji found that, you know, how God carries everything to the poor real devotees. Ananda Chinta, if you think of the Lord, that is the way. Swami told another story about Draupadi and that Bhishma. It is the Mahabharata war, as you know. Bhishma was the great hero. He decided, you know, this war will stop if I can kill those five brothers. Or Yudhishthira, Arjuna, those five brothers, if I kill them, the war will stop. So he told Duryodhana, "These are the five arrows I selected. tomorrow I shall kill all 5 brothers, the war will stop. And rule of the war is sunrise to sunset. After that, they are all friends. They go each other's camp. So Krishna heard it. Asked Yudhishthira that what will happen? I do not know. It is your job. We surrender ourselves to you. Now it is your job to protect us. Krishna was in trouble. He was telling Arjuna, Arjuna, do one thing. You go and ask Duryodhana to take his royal dress, which he offered once to you when you won the war. So Arjuna went to Duryodhana's camp in the tent. Hey Arjuna, how are you? Well, I'm doing fine. Well, why are you here? Well, I just came to beg one thing from you. Anything. Well, I want your royal dress. Oh, this is the thing. Take it. I have so many royal dresses. So with the royal dress, he went to Bhishma's tent. And Bhishma was, with closed eyes. Well, Grandpa, I have to again come. What is the matter? Well, you selected those 5 arrows to kill the Pandavas tomorrow. Hey, somebody may take them away. Let me take those things and keep, and in a safe place I want to keep in my tent. All right, there you take them. So he took. And then he could not recognize Arjuna. And it is all Krishna's magic. Then afterwards, Krishna came to Bhishma's tent. Grandfather, how are you? I'm okay. What is the matter? I heard that you are going to kill 5 brothers tomorrow with 5 arrows. Just now I heard that Arjuna took away those arrows. What? Arjuna took away those arrows? Yes. You did all this mischief, Krishna. All right? As you broke my vows, tomorrow I shall break your vow. Krishna took the vow that in the Mahabharata war he will not touch any weapon. He will be only the charioteer of Krishna, of Arjuna. So what happened? Bas. Next day Bhishma began terrible fight, killing all the armies of the Pandavas. At that time, Krishna jumped from the chariot and took his Sudarshan Chakra and wanted to kill Bhishma. Then he dropped his arms and he Devesha Jagannivasa, come, O Krishna, kill me. Then Arjuna went, jumped and begged Krishna, I shall fight. He was hesitant to fight with grandfather. So I shall fight, please come back. Then again the war began. Anyhow, the story is, God even breaks his vows to protect the devotees. Sri Ramakrishna says, those who make rules, they can change rules. That Sri Ramakrishna demonstrated. How Sri Ramakrishna argued with people? Mathura said, Father, God makes the rule and nobody can change the rule. What do you say? White flower tree only grows white flower. Red flower trees only grow white and red flowers. Sri Ramakrishna said, no. God can change the rules. How? Next day, Sri Ramakrishna showed that one twig, one red flower, one white flower, he broke the twig and showed to Mathura. Mathura looked. The mother changed the rule. But we had a Swami Gauri Sharananda. He was Mother's disciple. And he said, he was the rose Swami. He was the judge of the roses in India. He said, I have more power than Ramakrishna. Ramakrishna only showed 2 flowers on one stem. I can graft 5 colors of flowers of roses on one tree. So one tree I can show. And then see, it has 5 colored flowers. So I am more powerful than Ramakrishna. We should enjoy this stuff. Gauri Sharananda. offer everything. Main thing is love. Real love. Tvameva sarvam gatsya tvameva tvameva sarvam mama deva deva. You are my all in all, Lord. Love. We don't know how to love. Swamiji said love is a triangle. The first angle of the love triangle is love knows no fear. While there is fear, there cannot be love. Sometimes you can see the opera, they can put a gun on your chest. Do you love me? Yes, 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 I love you. No, lies. through that, what is called through the fear, love never comes. Second, angle of the love triangle is love knows no bargain. I shall give $1 million, will you love me one day? She said, yes, yes, sure. Love cannot be bought. It spontaneously comes from the heart. When some people, you know, beating us, love me. Are you? If somebody doesn't love me, go. It cannot be forced. It cannot be. It doesn't. Love and, I always say, love and religion cannot be forced. No way. It must come spontaneously from the heart. I cannot make people spiritual. If you do not have hunger, you will reject my food. I may cook fancy dishes for you. Main thing is the hunger. That Sri Ramakrishna demonstrated in this age. Hunger for God, longing for God, yearning for God. When that yearning, longing comes, do you know what does it mean? That Thakur said, Sri Ramakrishna said, golden glow in the eastern horizon. The sun has not yet risen, but sun will rise very soon. That is the indication. The golden glow in the morning, sun will rise very soon. So when this yearning, longing comes, we know God realization is very, very close. I think I talked enough. If we have any questions, please ask. Don't feel shy. I am supposed to speak 1 hour and 1.5 hour and half an hour question and answer.
She has a question.
Yes.
You spoke of the two blades of self-surrender and grace. But you also spoke, self-effort and grace.
Self-effort and grace.
And you also spoke of surrender.
Mm-hmm.
So how does surrender and self-effort go together?
That is the reason the parable says that two ways. One way is the monkey's little baby monkey grabs the mother and mother jumps from one tree to the other. That is, she is the ladybug monkey, the baby monkey is making an effort so that I can reach my destination. And the kitten are complete surrender, 100% surrender. There is a fear of fall of the baby monkey, but there is no fear of fall from the mother kitten, that kitten. You see, it is true that, you know, for that reason, as long as you have ego, self-surrender will not come. That problem is in the ego. Oof. I had a disciple, he was telling, Swami, I have a little ego problem. I'm going to read it. I said, Rita, are you the Miss Universe? No, Swami. Do you have millions of dollars? No, Swami. Do you have a PhD degree? No, Swami. Then what do you have? Yeah. People become proud either of their physical beauty or money or, you know, learning, education. They become proud. What do you have? You are right, Swami, but still I have pride, you know. Ego. As long as you have ego, that 100% self-surrender is not possible. look what happened. Thakur went to Radhavada, the Stooji, to see how they take the photograph. He had the curiosity to see a photograph. So the cameraman was explaining, do you see? Here is the negative. One side is an emulsion, silver nitrate. There you can check the impression of the face, and that from that negative you can make hundreds of prints. The moment Sri Ramakrishna saw it, he went into samadhi. Why? This person, if his mind or her mind is a coating of devotion, then the impression of God will be there. And he can see God all the time. So he went. Then while returning in the horse carriage, he was thinking, he would find it, it is in the gospel. You know, today I'm going to Bishop's house. I shall tell him this, I shall tell him that, I shall tell him this. He's planning. Immediately, he's in horse carriage. He was so dizzy, he was about to fall. Oh, mother, not ma. Mother, I shall not speak. You speak. Mother, you speak. Mother, you speak. Mother, I'm not I, not I. Wait, that way he got rid of his dizziness. When we read these things, we know we can feel what is called true religion. 100%. When he says, I cannot touch money, he cannot touch money. Even people, Swamiji tested him putting a coin under his mattress. He came from the temple, sat, oof, jolegalo, jolegalo, jolegalo. Burning, burning. Open the, see what is there. Swamiji was testing that whether really he conquered. Really, when I say, that is the reason, in the beginning I told you, Sri Ramakrishna opened the lap. It is really a spiritual phenomenon in this age. You can see many yogis, gurus, babas in this country. But why is Sri Ramakrishna inquire of these people? I said, they said, there is no hypocrisy in Ramakrishna's religion. But the numbers will be all the same. That happened. One day Sri Ramakrishna in Dakshineshwari asked Latu Maharaj, could you count how many devotees I have? He is the most illiterate one. He asked him to count. Noto khatale ek trishyo. Latu counted 31. I said, the next joke, you over get 30. Look, I am nearly 80, 90 people are here. I am not bad. The avatar, God incarnate, is only 31 devotees. One, you know what, one Swami made a joke. Yeah, you see, what Sri Ramakrishna recruited, he recruited only generals. And you will recruit only infantry. Anyhow, look, that 100% that I shall not say, Mother, you. That is the reason when Romarola wrote Sri Ramakrishna's biography, he wrote a sentence, I shall never forget. Sri Ramakrishna's eye died forever. One of our devotees in Santa Barbara, he was my close friend. One of the persons came and said, it is a very good religious book, please read. He read in 2 pages and he found nearly 40 eyes in 2 pages. So he went into his room and brought the Gospel of Ramakrishna and he said, could you find out how many eyes is there? Sri Ramakrishna said, I. Sri Ramakrishna never could speak I and mine. Ekanka, this place, Ekane, here, in this way he used to point out himself. I and my will not come from his lips. Amazing phenomenon. He was asking the doctor, you put money on my hand? He put money on his hand. It is in Shampur house. Cancer. Immediately his breath stopped. They put the stethoscope, no heartbeat. Amazing, he demonstrated. That is the reason I started. You start open the lab. Read, say Ramakrishna, the divine play and the gospel of Ramakrishna. I wrote an article recently. Ramakrishna Shastra, Ramakrishna scripture. What is Krishna's scripture? Christ's life and teachings? What is Muslim scripture? Muhammad's life and his Quran, Allah? That is the scripture. Buddhist scripture, Tripitakas. Ramakrishna scripture, Ramakrishna is the divine play and the gospel. These are the scriptures. His life and his message. Yes.
Alright. Today you started with Swamiji's, Swami Vishuddhananda's Sarvadharman Purityajya. Right? I like to think, please correct me if I'm wrong, had it been that easy, Lord Krishna would not have said it at the almost at the end of his teachings.
Sure.
He went through his Karma Yoga, Gyan Yoga, Dhyana Yoga, all these went on and on and on, and at last he said. So in our life, is it not most difficult? Please correct me or please explain.
If it is impossible. Even now, do not see the time that way. Na dharma vritteshu vaya samikshati. Religion, spirituality cannot be determined by age. Sometimes we think in old age, at that time we shall 100% surrender. You can surrender at any stage in your life. And it is, you see, Sri Ramakrishna Krishna smashed his ego. Nasrakshasi, binakshasi. If you do not listen to me, you will be destroyed. Not only that, do you know what happened? If you read in the Bhagavatam, there is a stop, him on Krishna by Bhishma. Do you know what Bhishma said? Krishna is not lying. In the 11th chapter, when he said, Nihata Sarve Evete, I have killed all these people. These 18 million people are all killed. What do you mean? 18 million people are already there in the battlefield. War has not yet been begun. Then Bhishma said, O Krishna, when you came, when Arjuna asked you, drive my chariot between the belligerent armies, I want to see who has come to fight with me. Do you know what did he do? He just looked and took away the longevity of all these 18 million people. They are all standing, Nimitta, be the witness. I have all killed them. They are all killed. If you do not fight, they will die. I want you to be the establisher of religion. That is the reason I am asking you to do it. Same thing, Swamiji, as Krishna forced Arjuna to fight, Thakur forced Swamiji to work. When Swamiji refused, I shall not do it, but your heart will go, your very bone will go. You have come with a mission. That is the way it works. Bas, thank you. Our next session will start at 4 o'clock. Come on, take your instruments.